So the students that we, the tools that we need in physics, we apply maths, that is calculus, the branch of mathematics that we need the most in physics. And calculus has two branches, differentiation and integration. So we also call it differential calculus, and then derivative. So we have a function, this f of x, and then we find the, so this is our function, and then we find the slope function. Slope function means slope of this function at any point x, and that will be d by dx of f of x. So this is the slope function. We can, so put value of x here, you will find the, means what is the value of function at that point, and put the value of x here and derivate, do the, you know, derivation, you means find the slope function first and then you put the value, you'll find the slope at that particular point. In integration, so here this is a slope function, and integration we also call it integral calculus. So integral, and see the symbol of differentiation is this d of dx, and here the symbol is, this is long s, okay, long s, and this long s. So f of x is there, here also we have f of x. So the dx, this dx comes here, and this d changes to this. So what does this tell us? This is equals to, if f of x is your function, this is your function f of x, this will give you the slope function, and this will give you the area under the curve f of x. So this integration, it will give you the area under the curve f of x. So in simple terms, here we find the area, and in differentiation we find the slope. And you know, we need both the things. So we have in this, when we were deriving the equations of motion graphically, then we have written that this is the area is equals to, so the units of velocity on the y-axis is meter per second, and the units of time is second. So the area, the units of area will be meter per second into second, that is meter. So it tells me that this is displacement, or if motion is in a straight line, then distance and displacement are same. Now, and then we find the slope of the line AB, and that's comes out to be, so which physical quantity I will get as slope? So
acceleration.
Yes. So we will be dividing the units, because slope is change in y-axis upon change in x-axis. So rise by run. So the units of rise is meter per second. The units of run is second. So units will be meter per second square. And this gives me acceleration. Now, the point is that instead of this graph, if you have this graph, then how you are going to find out? Because here you have calculated area simply by adding the area of triangle plus area of rectangle, right? And slope also, you know the straight formula, that the slope of this line will be change in y-axis, that is v minus v naught upon change in x-axis, that is t. So it was very easy to find out when you have regular figures like this. But you, when you have irregular figures, you have curves, how you are going to find the slope at a particular point? How you are going to find out the area under this curve? Because the area under this curve is your displacement. And the slope at any point will give you the acceleration at this point. So from the velocity time graph, tangent at any point will give you the acceleration, and the area under the curve from this particular time, suppose this is 2 seconds, this is 4 seconds. So how much is the displacement from 2 to 4 seconds? So here in this, because this uniform motion, and for uniform motion we have equations. This is uniform motion, and from the uniform motion, using these area, concept of area and slope, we derive the relations v is equals to u plus at, s is equals to ut plus half at square, and v square minus u square is equals to 2as. So these equations only work when we have uniform motion, because we uniform motion means constant velocity. Not means see, velocity is not constant. So this, that's not students, acceleration is actually constant, this slope is constant. Uniform motion, you know, uniform motion means velocity is constant. So here velocity is not constant. Velocity is constant when you will have vt, this graph. Here we have velocity is constant. But here you can see that there is acceleration. So when this velocity is constant, then we say uniform motion. So this motion is have constant acceleration. Okay, so uniform acceleration, constant acceleration, uniform acceleration. So when we have uniform acceleration, then only we can apply these equations. But if the equation is, but if the acceleration is not uniform, like in this case, so students, uniform acceleration only means this graph. This is not the graph of uniform motion, because velocity is not constant. So we have two terms, uniform motion and uniform acceleration. See, meaning of uniform is constant. Meaning of uniform, uniform is an adjective and it means constant. Now motion means velocity, and acceleration is acceleration. So uniform motion means constant velocity, uniform acceleration means constant acceleration. So these equations work for uniform motion as well as uniform acceleration, these equations. But these equations will not work if acceleration is not uniform, means acceleration is changing. Here there is different slope, here there is different slope. So different slope. So here the slope was constant. Here the slope is changing. So acceleration is not uniform. So we cannot use these equations for this graph to find the displacement. So how we are going to find the displacement in this case? See, this case is something like when your car, you know, your car starts and suddenly you speed up your car. You are speeding up and you feel a jerk. When there is sudden change in speed, you feel a jerk. Like you go to adventure park. So you're riding like there are some machines in which you go up and down, right? So sudden up, you feel thrill, you are thrilled. Sudden down, you feel you are thrilled. But if you are coming at constant velocity, then there is no thrill. Okay, so when there is a uniform motion or even uniform acceleration, you don't feel the thrill. But here you feel the thrill when acceleration is not uniform. So students, we want to find out, so how to find out the area and the slope when we have this kind of curve. So that's what we want to learn. So we have already learned how to find the slope of this. So acceleration at this point will be given by rate of change of velocity. So dv by dt. So delta v by delta t is the average, but dv by dt is the instantaneous acceleration. So here, when we want to find instantaneous change in y with respect to x, we find this slope at this point, slope of the tangent with dy by dx. So we did it in last class. Now in today's class, we want to do the second thing, that is try to find the area under the curve. So as I told you that here in this diagram also, we need this area to find the displacement. Now further, where else do we need it? Like, I have this block over here, and I am applying a force of 10 Newton on this block, and this block is moved by 5 meters. So I am regularly applying the force of 10 Newton and it moved 5 meter. So how much is the work done, students? Work done will be, see, this is the graph. We have displacement over here and this is the force. So its units are Newton and its unit is meter. So work done is equal to force into displacement. Yes. So how
much? Yes, sir.
10
yes,
Newton sir. Into displacement 5 meter.
So 50 Newton meter.
50 Newton meter, that is 50 joules, right? Now,
yes, sir.
Now here in this case, you had the constant force. The force was constant. So this was your displacement, that is 5 meter. And throughout this displacement 5 meter, your force was constant 10 Newton. So you have found this area. So that is, this area is work done. Now, what happens that instead, so this is very easy to find the area, but if you have a curve like this, so how you are going to find out the area? With that is force. So here in this case, constant force was there. So constant force was constant throughout the motion, 10 Newton. But here, we have this force is variable force. See, the force was this much at this point of time. The force was changed at this point of time. Force was again changed at this point of time. But see here, at this not time, but the meter, when the displacement was this much, the force was this. When the displacement was this, so you are increasing the force up to this point, and then you are decreasing the force that you are applying. But here, at 1 meter, force was 2 Newton. At 2 meter, force was 10 Newton. At 3 meter displacement, the force was 10 Newton. At 4 meter, so constant force. So for constant force, this formula works. But if the force is variable, then this formula is not going to work. For that, what we need to do? This is what we are going to learn, how to find out the area. So a simple thing, what we can do is, we can divide this into strips. Vertical strips, this into vertical strips. And what will be the area of one strip? Area of one strip will be delta A, that is equals to force into small displacement. Because we are assuming, now we are applying the formula of constant force for one strip. So for one strip like this one, you can assume that the force is constant, that is fx. See, here we have fx. Fx means this force also depends on displacement. Like here it was vt, so velocity was depending on time, velocity was changing as per the time. So here force is changing as per the displacement. So how can we find the strip of one strip? We can find for this strip, we can assume the force as constant. Only for this particular displacement, we assume the force as constant. So force into displacement, we get the area, that is your small work done. And then adding all these strips. So if we, so look here, if we add all these strips, like from xi, initial displacement to final displacement, we divide it into vertical strips, and we are, so area of one strip we have found f of x into dx, into delta x, and that, then adding all them, have you used this sign, student, summation sign, summation?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so summation, yes, means adding them all, right? So adding all fx, delta x, adding all the areas from where to where? Xi to xf. Okay, so xi to xf, we are adding all the areas and we get the work done. But see, here you can see that this will the approximate work done. Why? Because here the force is changing here actually, and we are assuming the force to be constant. So we need to make these strips thinner, as thin as possible. As thin as possible. Like there we were approaching delta x tends to 0. Here we were approaching, this was delta x. So here we were approaching, when we were moving from q to p, so we were approaching delta x approaches to 0. So we have never reached delta x, because if delta x will be 0, then the slope will be not slope will not be defined. So delta y by delta x, so limit delta x approaches to 0. But if delta x equals to 0, then it will be not defined. So delta y is decreasing and delta x is also approaching 0. When you move, so this line, this secant line, or this chord PQ will become tangent here. And that we write as dy by dx. So we discussed this in the last class. So here delta x was approaching to 0, because why? Like here you have, like velocity was equals to delta x by delta t. So that's the average velocity. If I want to find that velocity, if this is time displacement, displacement time graph. So, but I want to find, this was average velocity, but I want to find the instantaneous velocity. So for instantaneous velocity, I need to take this delta t interval as little as possible, as little as possible. So the smaller the interval is, this time interval, the smaller this interval is, more my average value will be equal to the instantaneous velocity. More this delta t approaches to zero, more this average will become instantaneous. So similarly, the case here, thinner delta x is, so here also delta x is approaches to zero. So the thinner this delta x is, force will be more constant. And force will be more constant, so we are, because we are applying the formula to calculate the small work done, for the assuming that this force fx is constant for this displacement delta x. So thinner the strip is, more appropriate my area will be, more appropriate my work done will be. So adding all those strips, so if there are finite strips, means finite delta w, then summation will take place. But if delta x tends to 0, then this sign of summation turns into integral sign. Okay, so in differentiation, this was my average velocity, to find the instantaneous velocity. So instantaneous velocity, when I limit this delta t tends to 0, means my delta t is very very small, very very small, so this average will be more nearer to the instant. And instead of writing this whole thing all the time, I write it as dx by dt. So derivative of x with respect to t. Now in the case of integration, like this work done is equals to small work done is equals to f of x into delta x. So this force is variable force, it depends on x. Now I want to find total work done, so I will be adding all these small work. What I am doing, I am adding all these small work from xi to xf. Okay, now so this work is approximate, because I told you that here even this you are assuming that for this particular delta x force is constant, because you are applying the formula of constant force, which is f into x, constant force, and force is changing. So more thinner this delta x is, lesser this delta x is. So to find exact, so this approximation will be changing to exact if we are taking the limit delta x tends to 0. So if I take delta x tends to 0, then this approximation thing, the only change is that if I take this limit, that the approximation thing will be changed into equal to. And now how shall I write this whole thing? So this whole thing, so number of strips have become, so number of delta x strips, this n will tends to infinity, so very little strips, so for those strips force will be constant. And how to write this, like I have written this whole thing as this in short form, so how to write it in short form? See this integration sign. So integration sign, this sign means sum of all from where to where, xi to xf, from this displacement xi to xf, and this fx and this delta sign, like here delta sign was changed to d, so here this delta sign will also change to d. So students, this is the way of writing this. Instead of writing it like this, we can write it like this. So we use integral calculus to find the area under the curve. Students, by doing these two concepts of calculus, you have done almost 50% of the basics that you require to study physics. And means graphs and this calculus, graphs plus calculus, slope graph calculus. And 50% of the remaining thing is vectors and vector algebra. So 100% tools will be with you, and you will face no problems if you know these tools. So students, half of the work is done that we require to study physics, and half of the work will be done in the next 3 days when we will do vectors and vector algebra. So you need to show your patience, and for just this week, so that all your basics, see this is a bridge between 10th and 11th class, you need this bridge. So when we walk on land, things are different, but here you are walking on bridge, you are constructing bridge and you are walking on it. So things are quite different. And when we look into the valley, which is under the bridge, we are frightened. Oh my God! What's this? But unless and until you will walk on this, on that bridge, you will not be able to move on. Because you have reached the edge. Now you need to go on to another height. And there is a valley in between. So what you are going to do? You need a bridge. And you need to cross that bridge. So students, we are constructing that bridge. And half of the work is done, as I told you. And the best point you have is that you have the recorded lectures also. And then you can post me your queries. Sir, I have not understood this thing. You can WhatsApp me your queries. You can ask your queries. Students.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, this formula you have derived, sir, this is related to, sir, force. So if you have to find the area under the curve of the velocity time graph, so same procedure.
That's a good question. See, if you have, this is your velocity time graph, and this is your curve. This curve be of any shape, and this is the time ti to tf, right? So, you have to find this area which will be your displacement. So, S is equals to, now what formula do we use? If you want to use, apply it over here, okay. So, to find this, we need to divide it into vertical strips. Yes. And we are assuming the velocity to be constant for this particular, because see, s is equals to ut plus half at square. So if initial velocity equals to final velocity, means this velocity is constant, means acceleration is zero. So if a is equals to zero, then this formula turns s is equals to u into t. So this u can be your average velocity, this u can be your constant velocity. So you are assuming that this velocity is constant for this particular time, which is delta t. So this vertical strip, one strip you have taken, delta t time, and velocity is, you are assuming it as v. So writing v into delta t is your small displacement, right? Now same thing. Now you want to find the whole displacement, so you will be adding all these strips. So this v depends on t, because this is changing. So you will be adding from ti to tf, right, this vt into delta t. So adding all the strips, so you will get approximate, not the work done, but the displacement here. So you will get the displacement, same thing like we did here. So instead of f we are writing v, and instead of x we are writing t. So we have replaced f with v and x with t. Rest of the things are same. So here again displacement will be exactly equal to, if we limit delta t tends to zero, means this strip should be as thin as possible, then only velocity will be constant, and then only this formula will be appropriate. And adding from ti to tf all the displacement. So limiting this approximation sign will change to equal to sign. And now further, this s will be equals to, now this whole thing, like here it changed to integration, right? The summation sign changed to integration if this is infinity, right? And then vt into dt, and here ti to tf. See, that is the beauty of physics, that once you have learned one concept, you can apply it on all the variables throughout physics. So physics, that is why physics is one of the easiest subject. But as the people who have a habit of cramming and the people who have a habit of only, you know, means those who don't want to apply their mind, no reasoning, nothing, then, and they don't want to write down, they want to, don't want to practice with understanding, then the physics becomes difficult subject. So it depends on your mindset and study skills. Otherwise, physics, you can see, is one of the easiest subjects. Okay, students, noted it down? Yes?
Done, sir.
Noting, sir.
Okay.
Noting, sir.
Okay, okay, note down, note down. Take your time.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, here is sigma, oh, submission TINTF, then we are using V bracket T. This is for the whole, this, all the distance, that all the velocity that has been covered, or for a specific velocity.
Very good question. See, this is the specific velocity at time. See, velocity is a VT means what? VT means it can be 2T square plus 3T plus 5. This VT can be equals to 5T square minus 7. So means the velocity is depends on time. So this is a different question. So these are two different cases. So these are different cases. Velocity can be this. In different scenario, velocity can be this. So graph will be different for those both the functions. So you have to put these values over here. These values. You have to put these values over here.
Okay, sir.
See, this is the equation of curve. This curve that you have drawn here. So this is the equation of that curve. So in differentiation and integration both, like you want to write the formula for differentiation. So what is d by dt of vt? What you will get, students? Rate of change of velocity. What is rate of change of velocity?
Acceleration.
Yes. So if you find the rate of change of velocity, it's acceleration. If you find the if you are multiplying v into t and adding all those small strips, then you will get the displacement. So that's the area and that's the slope for the curve. Like Vt, we discussed it, that if the graph is not a regular figure, then how we are going to find out? So suppose this curve, you can assume that this is, suppose this is a curve. Okay, so you can find the area under this curve with this equation. Okay. And you can find the slope function, which is acceleration, using this function. So now you can find the area as well as slope using these two functions first, and using the integration you can find the displacement, find the area under the curve, and using the derivative you can find the slope function. So students, see, that is why we need the calculus to find the area and the slope. So slope at any point and the area under the curve. So that is the purpose of learning this differentiation and integration. Because either we will be dividing the variables or we will be multiplying the variables. So whenever we will be multiplying the variables, then integration will be used because you will be finding the area. When we are dividing the variables, then it will be differentiation and you will be finding the slope. Change in y-axis, change in one variable divided by change in another variable. So you are finding the instantaneous change slope. Okay, students?
Yes, sir.
So, students, as I told you that you people are quite, I must say, brave hearts. So, just show a little bit of patience and write it down again. Write it again with complete understanding. Okay? So students, this is all that we have discussed with you, that I have discussed with you, that if this is the, if you have a constant force, then it's not a issue. Work done is equals to force into displacement. Displacement is B minus A, that is your displacement. So work done is equals to force into this displacement, that is B minus A. And but what if you have a variable force? So if you have a variable force, so here the formula for the constant force was force into displacement. But when you have a variable force, then the formula will be f of x dx xi to xf. So that will be your work done. Okay, students, so this is all theory. You can read this theory. Okay, this is there in your NCERT also, at the end of chapter number 3, differentiation and integration. So whatever I have discussed with you, it is written over here. Okay. So students, please ask any questions. If you would like to ask, it will be a good thing. So just ask questions. Yes, any questions, students?
No, sir.
See, your duty, गीता में लिखा है कि आपका काम कर्म करना, आपका काम कोशिश करने का, समझने का. अभी तो हम इतना यूज करेंगे कि मतलब आपको within 1 week, 10 days आपके टिप्स पे हो जाएंगे. जब आप किसी रास्ते से पहली बार जाते हैं, अनजान रास्ता है, लेकिन जब आप उसी रास्ते दो बार जाते हैं, तीन बार जाते हैं, चार बार जाते हैं, पांच बार जाते हैं, तो आपको एक एक चीज याद जाती है कि सड़क पे यहाँ गड्ढा मिलेगा, यहाँ पर जो राइट साइड में ये टर्न मिलेगा, यहाँ स्पीड ब्रेकर मिलेगा. तो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट यू पीपल आर पासिंग थ्रू दिस, वॉकिंग ऑन दिस रोड, पासिंग थ्रू दिस एरिया. तो फिर उसके बाद हैबिट हो जाएगी, तो इट विल नॉट बी ए प्रॉब्लम. चलिए अब हम थोड़ा सा जो है, थोड़े से ये ज्योमेट्रिकल मीनिंग तो वी हैव अंडरस्टूड, डिफरेंशिएशन एंड इंटीग्रेशन. ओके, नाउ लेट अस डू सम क्वेश्चंस. तो डिफरेंशिएशन, डेरिवेटिव, वेलोसिटी dx by dt, acceleration dv by dt. So this x is a function of t and this velocity is also a function of t. Integration, finding the area. So see, velocity is equals to displacement upon time, delta x by delta t, and acceleration is equal to dv by dt. So what is displacement equals to? Velocity into time. What is acceleration equals to? What is velocity equals to?
Acceleration, acceleration into time.
Yes. So write the formula of integration using these. So what will be your net displacement? You'll be adding up all the means velocity is varying. Yes. And with respect to time, so how the time is varying? Ti to Tf. Now what is the equation for this? Yes, you are going to tell me, students. Yes. Total yes. Yes, this velocity will be equals
to
yes.
A total sum of all.
All the
sum of areas. Acceleration, time.
Yes, okay.
Acceleration, time, so del derivative of
changing. Okay. Yes. So Ti to Tf. This is the change. So change is here. And acceleration is a function of time and dt. So see students, from here I have written this. from this I have written this formula. Yes. So these formulas are of averages, and this is the formula for instantaneous. And you know that in these formulas, in so to change from here to here, the condition we have taken is that the limit delta t tends to 0. So it reaches from averages to instantaneous. And here also, so from this formula to this formula, and from this formula to this one. So this is, we are finding the area under curve in integration. And here in differentiation, we are finding the slope of tangent. So that is the geometrical meaning. Now how shall I find the values algebraically? Okay. Let us see one question. You have studied quadratic functions. The simplest quadratic function y is equals to x square. And this is the graph of that function. Now, what is the slope? So you see that the slope is changing at every point. So what will the slope function? So slope function will be dy by dx. This is your x, and this is y. And y is a function of x. So that is equals to, so see y is a function of x, x square. So put the value of x square here. Now students, tell me what will be the differentiation of this. Yes. Tell me. Yes. Come on.
2x.
Yes. 2x.
Yes. Very good. Power will come as coefficient. Power will become coefficient. Yes. Power has become coefficient and reduce the power by 1. Okay. So two steps, simple steps. What you need to do first? So as a general formula, d by dx of x raised to the power n. So the formula is n will become coefficient and reduce the power by 1. So is this clear, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the area? Same graph I'm drawing again. So this is the slope function. What is the benefit of this slope function, students? What is the benefit of it? See, your function was x square. This was your function. And your slope function is, we write the slope function as y dash . See, these are the three ways, 1, 2, 3, of saying the same thing. Derivative of, so this also means the derivative of y with respect to x. This also means derivative of y with respect to x. This also means. So all of them is this differentiation of y. This also differentiation of the function f of x. So all of them, all three of them have the same meaning. And this slope function is 2x. So at x is equals to 1, what is the value of function? Y is equals to
2.
1 square, that is 1. So the coordinates will be 1, 1, right? XY coordinates. Yes? So what is the slope at this point? 1, 1. What is the slope at this point? 1, 1. So slope is equals to 2x. And 2 into 1?
2.
2. So the slope is 2, students. Got it? Now, see this curve is actually, you know, it's like this. So this was your x equals to 1. Now this x equals to 2. Okay. So what is the slope at x equals to 2? What is the coordinate? What is the value of y? So here the coordinates were 1, 1, Now what will be the coordinates here, students? 2 and 2 square? 4.
4.
4.
2, so, 4.
2, 4. So the coordinates here are 2, 4. Very good. Now what is the slope here? See, you can see that the slope is different. At this point, the slope is this. Here the slope is this. So slope is different. Tan theta is different for those both the cases. Here the theta is different. Here the theta is different, right? So what is the slope at 2, 4? Simple, you have the slope function, that is the advantage. Simply write 2 into, what is x? 2, so 2 into 2, that's 4. Now, at coordinate x equals to 100, now you cannot draw the graph at that point, but what will be the change if x becomes 100? This can be your profit. Suppose you are manufacturing this these many units and you are getting a profit of this much. So, it can be applied anywhere. Okay, so we are studying how one variable is depending on other variable. So if x is 100, what will the value of y?
10,000.
Yes, absolutely, 10,000 students. And the coordinate will be 100 and 10,000. Very good. Now what will be the slope?
200.
Yes, what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning? Let us find the meaning of this. See, slope is 2 means slope is rise upon run. Yes?
Yes, sir.
Rise upon run. So if you are changing x, so rise upon run means change in y-axis upon change in x-axis, right? So it means at this point, if you are changing x by, so this is 2 by 1, this is 4 by 1, this is 200 by 1. So if you are running with 1, running by 1, if you are changing x by 1 unit, y is changing by 200 units. If you move from 100, 201, y will be, if you move from 100 to 100.01, then changing y will be, means, what does this mean? This means that if change in x-axis is 1 unit, then change in y-axis will be 200
units
at x equals 200. See how much the slope is. 200 is the slope. So slope means, now you have understood the meaning of slope. What is the meaning of slope? Now, tell me, students, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3. This is 1, this is 2. Tell me the slope of this line now. Yes. Tell me the slope of this line.
1.
Yes.
1
or 2? Or is it something? See, how much is the change in x-axis? And how much is the change in y-axis? So slope is delta y by delta x. So the change in y-axis is 1 unit. Change in x-axis
one unit.
Is 2 units.
1 unit.
2 unit.
So slope is 0.5. So it means that if you are changing x by 1 unit, y will only be changed by half a unit. Yes? If here the change is 1, here the change will be 0.5. So students, now you have done another definition of slope. That slope tells you, this 200 slope means, if you change x-axis by 1 unit, then y, then the change in y unit will be 200. Here if you were changing when x equals to 2, when you were changing the slope, the x-axis by 1 unit, the change in y was 4 units. You can find the change. Look here. Put x equals to 101. What will y equals to? Yes, tell me, 101 into. So you can find it, 100 plus 1 square. And that's again 10,000 plus 1 plus 200, right? That is 10,201. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, x changes by how many units? 1 unit.
100.
How much is the change in y? This minus this. 201. So this is the average change. Slope is telling you the instantaneous change. So see, the change is, average change is 200 units and instantaneous change is 200 units. If you take this 1 as 0.01, the answer will be more near to 200. So here, because you will be dividing delta y by delta x, so here the change will be lesser, here again delta y will be lesser. So have you understood the meaning of slope, students? Slope means, slope is telling you the change in y-axis when the, so if slope is equals to m, what does this mean? It means change in y-axis is m units when changes in x is 1 unit. Means when delta x is equals to 1 unit, then delta y, change in y, will be equals to m units. Because that is the meaning of m is equals to delta y by delta x. Okay, students. Now you have understood the meaning of slope in another way. Got it? Watch this video again, students, okay? Now let us do some questions of this differentiation. D by dx of, you have a function x cube, students. Tell me the value of it.
3x.
3. So you are using this formula, d by dx of x is to n is equals to n x n minus 1. Yes.
3x squared.
Very good.
3x squared.
Now d by dx of 5x cube plus 2x. Yes. First of all, distributive law you will be using. Yes. And then bringing the constant outside. Yes. Now you can use this formula now. What do you get? Bring the power as coefficient and reduce
3x squared.
What will be dx by dx? Bring the power here, 1. And x raised to the power 1 minus 1 is 0 and x minus 0 is 1. So dx 1. By dx will be equals to 1. So you get 15x square plus 2. So that is the slope function. So your f of x was 5x cube plus 2x. So this was your function. And this is your slope function. This is your slope function. So slope function, you can write it as d by dx of f of x, or you can write it as, or you can further write it as, if this function is equals to, if you let it equals to y. Got it, students? Now what is integration? Last. See, algebraically, you do differentiation, you get f dash x. You do the integration, you comes back. See, geometrically, geometrically, differentiation means finding slope. Integration means finding area geometrically. But algebraically, see algebraically what it is, means you are finding d by dx of x square is equals to 2x, right? This is the first thing you have done. Now do the integration of 2x, you will get x square back. As simple as that, students. Got it? So what is the formula for integration? Do the reverse of what you have done in the differentiation. So what you did in the differentiation, x is bar n, n you have brought it as constant, as coefficient, and n minus 1. Now doing the integration of this, doing the integration of what you have got, that's equals to, bringing the n is constant, you can bring it outside. And now as you decrease the power by 1, so increase the power by 1, okay, and divide it as you have bought it in the multiply this n, now this power, divide it with this power. So what do you get? You get as n into, so increase the power by 1 because you have decreased it by 1, so increase it by 1, divided by, bring this power here, so n minus 1 plus 1 is power n, so n will cancels out, and this plus 1 minus 1, and you get x raised to the power n. So differentiating it, we get this, and integrating it, we get it back. So algebraically, both are, you know, one just reverses, so integration reverses the effect of differentiation. So if you want to write the formula for x raised to the power n, then the formula will be x raised to the power 1. So increase the power by 1 and divide it by 1. So that's the formula for differentiation, that's the formula for integration.
सर वी हैव टू डिवाइड द वी हैव टू व्हिच डिवाइड पावर डिवाइड करनी है सर.
हाँ आप करके देखो एक दो क्वेश्चंस, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, जब तक करेंगे नहीं सीखेंगे नहीं. एक क्वेश्चन और करके देखो, चलो ये करके देखो, ये फॉर्मूले दोनों लिख दिए ना मैंने आपके सामने. नाउ डू वन क्वेश्चन, एक्स क्यूब का आपने क्या किया, डिफ्रेंशिएशन करो पहले, एक्स क्यूब का डिफ्रेंशिएशन करो, सॉरी आई एम डूइंग इंटीग्रेशन, x क्यूब का डिफरेंशिएशन करो, x रेज बाय 4 का करो, चलो क्या आएगा,
4x क्यूब.
स्टूडेंट्स वेरी गुड, अब इसका इंटीग्रेशन करो 4x क्यूब का. ये फॉर्मूला यूज करना, अब आपको 4 बाहर आ गया, x क्यूब इंटू डी एक्स, 4 इंटू x क्यूब का क्या होगा, पावर को पहले इंक्रीज करो 1, और जो इंक्रीज हो गया उसी से क्या कर दो, डिवाइड. तो क्या आ गया, बस.
ओके सर,
तो आपने x रेज़ बाय 4 का डिफरेंशिएशन किया तो 4x क्यूब आ गया, 4x क्यूब का इंटीग्रेशन किया तो वापस वहीं पहुंच गए. तो इंटीग्रेशन इज इनवर्स ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन, डिफरेंशिएशन का उल्टा है इंटीग्रेशन. ज्योमेट्रिकली दोनों का मीनिंग बिल्कुल अलग अलग है. देखो ज्योमेट्रिकली तो एक हमें स्लोप बता रहा, दूसरा हमें क्या बता रहा है, एरिया. लेकिन जब हम एल्जेब्रिकली सॉल्व करते हैं तो एक जो है वो दूसरे के इफेक्ट को नलीफाई कर देता है, यानी कि वो इनवर्स फंक्शन है. सो इंटीग्रेशन इज इनवर्स ऑफ डिफरेंशिएशन. सो आई होप स्टूडेंट्स यू हैव अंडरस्टूड टुडेज लेक्चर. थैंक यू सो मच.